Let's talk about Mindanao. This is a boost for the vice president in Mindanao. But of course, you do have the tandem of Marcos Robredo in the surveys, essentially lording it over in Mindanao. Let's talk about the kind of support that you still believe are soft, that you can still get for the vice president in Mindanao.
It's I think that Mindanao, along with many other places in the Philippines, can still actually be reached in terms of the message the vice president is presenting in this election. I don't think that there's any place that we can or that we should simply write off and say wala na tayong magagawa diyan, 'di ba? Hindi na maabot diyan. Sa dulo, Pilipino lang laman lahat ng mga kababayan natin, 'di ba? Kahit man saan man silang probinsyang nakatira, pwedeng makausap, pwedeng makumbinse, pwedeng makasama pa. And I think that exactly the endorsement of Speaker Alvarez and Partido Reforma is proof positive of that. Na pwede pang magkaroon ng pakikipag-usap at kumbinsihan regardless of previous histories and regardless of perceived alliances in this election.
Okay, now Senator Manny Pacquiao, among the presidential candidates other than of course Mr. Marcos at this point, has strong showing in Mindanao. Is the group of the vice president, your whole team, still trying to dialogue? Are there backdoor negotiations or talks of asking Senator Manny Pacquiao to withdraw and instead support the vice president? Because those are votes that could go to one or the other.
Well, right now, the campaign is really focused on just doing its own thing. Because after all, there are only 45 days left in the campaign before we all go out to vote. But that said, there are groups outside of the campaign who have been continuously working since last year, since the filing of candidacies in October, to still try and bring together candidates from different groups to form a broader alliance. You know, you're trying to unite them under one tent and under one banner. So these are ongoing efforts. And the vice president has always been very, very clear. She is open to having conversations. She is open to exploring these unities. And 45 days is still an eternity in Philippine politics. Okay. So a lot of things can happen.
Okay. Now, there are 9 million votes, I believe, in Calabarzon. Am I correct?
More or less.
More or less. Okay. And you have the Remulias clearly going all out for Mr. Marcos. You have Batangas, which is a big voting bloc that's committed to Isko. In terms of the Calabarzon region, Barry, where do you believe is Robredo strong? What do you have, a bailiwick in Calabarzon?
Well, you have to understand, although there might be local leaders which support other candidates at the moment, we cannot say that simply because a prominent provincial leader supports a candidate, that that's the way the votes in that particular area will go. Mm-mm. Talking about Cavite, for example, while admittedly one of the governor is supporting another candidate, the fact is that when VP Leni had her own political rally in Cavite, you know, 47,000 people came. I mean, we did not expect that. I think even the local leaders did not expect that. That's why there was such a rush immediately after that event to try and explain away the numbers, but the thing is, this is a campaign and this is an election where the people themselves are slowly showing that they are willing to come out, they are willing to stand up for a candidate and a set of principles they believe in. And I think that that's true for Calabarzon as it is for every other place in the country. That's okay. Why our emphasis is really reaching out with the message, and people will respond regardless of the current political configurations.
Okay, now you've seen reports. I mean, prior, I actually covered former Senator Bongbong Marcos's motorcade that day for our special. Yes, but you've seen reports of Governor John Vic Rimulya handing out 25,000 pesos na papremyo in a mini rally before Marcos came. And just yesterday, another local official in Laguna, which was Sara Duterte's rally. Of course, Sara was not there yet, I think, or was not there anymore when money was given. But in rallies where they're in proximity, so to speak, or they're for them, there's money being handed out. Are you disappointed with the lack of action from the COMELEC?
Well, yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
I mean, the thing with in the age of social media is these things can no longer be concealed. So if somebody gives away money at a political rally, chances are, you know, within minutes of it happening, it will already be on social media. That's why we know that these things are happening. So it should be a case where the COMELEC should also be responsive to this kind of information. After all, we don't want the impression to arise that this election is being decided by, you know, out and out rampant vote buying. And quite honestly, I cannot frame it in any other way. If you're at a political rally and you're giving away money blatantly to the people attending, then that's really something of concern, and that's really something that our Commission on Elections should be taking action on.
Okay, my last question, because I still have another interview. A viewer is asking, since sacrifices are being made, will Senator Kiko, is he willing to step down and VP Lenny instead endorse Soto as a partner, which is a Lenny Soto ticket? Because you do have other local officials that are now Rosa, Robredo, Sara, right? Which is not unique because there was Noybi, Pinoy Binay. So this is quite common. But is that a possibility?
Well, right now, I don't think it's a possibility. The vice president has been very, very clear. Her choice for VP, the person that she will be campaigning for up to the end, will be Senator Kiko Pangilinan. And that's been clear from the start. We understand that there will be groups, there will be parties, there will be local officials who will choose to have some other configuration. And you know, we respect them. That's the thing with our system. The president and the vice president are not elected in tandem. But insofar as the vice president and insofar as the campaign is concerned, our vice presidential bet is Senator Kiko Pangilinan, and we will be doing everything we can in the next 45 days to ensure that he, who has been chosen by the vice president as her preferred partner in governance, will be elected as VP come May.
Okay. All right. In my interview with Pulse Asia, and actually when I was with Mr. Marcos in Cavite, reiterated by Pulse Asia is it seems he has the CDE crowd. That's why Pulse Asia didn't even include the B in the survey, the B class. Ang tanong ng marami, supporting Vice President Lenny Robredo, how will she connect, or does she even have the CDE crowd, Barry?
I don't actually agree that she does not have the CDE crowd.
Mm-mm.
Because if you look at the at her support over the years, some of her strongest support actually comes from Class E. And the reason for that is simply that the VP has been very, very active in her anti-poverty Angat Buhay program, which targets mostly poor communities, the communities on the Laylayan, and works to actually make their lives better. So insofar as her own background, her message, her platforms, these are really targeted more towards Class C, D, and E. Mm-hmm. And I think that it's just really a matter of time before there is a realization on the part of more voters coming from these classes that their interests are better served under a Lenny Robredo presidency. The biggest thing that we have to contend with not just in this election, but in previous years prior to the election, has been disinformation, particularly disinformation on social media. And I think that's the reason why many of the accomplishments and many of the advocacies of the vice president have not reached the people or have not been made known to more people in our country, unfortunately. But this is a campaign. We have been working on that the past few months. We still have 45 days left, and I am confident that we are slowly actually getting our message across to more people, and that's reflected in the growing support on the ground for VP Lenny. And hopefully that will snowball in the remaining 45 days of the campaign.
All right. Thank you very much for joining me today, Barry Gutierrez. Good luck to you, sir.
Thank you, Karen. Always happy to be here. Stay safe.